Just in sitting here in this beautiful garden and this beautiful villa outside Madrid, it's hard to imagine that this nomadic life that you're leading with Charlton Heston has any disadvantages. I'm sure it must have.
Well, the only disadvantage is that it doesn't go on all the time. I wish I could stay.
And what are the main advantages of this globe-trotting existence of yours?
There certainly are a lot of those. Oh, I should say the exposure to a new culture is perhaps the most exciting one. And the people, a chance to really see things the way an ordinary tourist never has an opportunity. It's, for example, last year when we worked in this little village out on the coast, a village called Peñíscola, I went around and took pictures for 6 weeks while my poor husband was struggling with his sword as the seed. I went around and took pictures. It was such a marvelous time.
How are your two children? You have a boy age 6 and a girl age 1. What particular problems are involved in this respect?
Oh, Stuart, I really don't think there's any conscious adaptation at all. Of course, there is the problem of school.
Yeah,
all nomadic actors have that, of course. But I'm going to have to take Fraser back in about a week to California to start school. I think he simply accepts that this is the way we live.
Does he miss the absence of your husband a great deal?
Oh, yes, of course he does, when Chuck is gone. But Chuck writes all the time and he calls. I think communication is really the answer to that problem. And after all, actors aren't the only people who have this difficulty. Doctors have it, sailors have it, salesmen have it.
Yes. Of course, having been an actress yourself in the theater and in the cinema as well, this makes you more sympathetic to his problems of being abroad all the time and taking the family with him.
Yes, well, Chuck says the only actress who can make a successful wife for an actor is a non-dedicated actress, which I'm afraid I was. But I think I do understand the problems of his job. But as I say, they really aren't so terribly unique after all.
Well, who better than you to talk about Charlton Heston, the father and husband, and yourself? At home, is he man, is he? Is he practical? Does he repair things? Can he cook? Does he cook, in fact?
I would like to be able to say that he's a man of dark moods and furies and so on. But frankly, I'll have to admit that he is a very easy person to live with. He's easygoing, he's optimistic in every way. He always expects that everything will work out for the best, and this is quite an asset in the home.
Is he a practical man of...
Maha, if he had a saw. yes, I would say he's a very practical man.
What are his hobbies, Mrs. Heston? He has, I think he paints, doesn't he?
His main hobby is tennis. I should say that was his main insanity at this point. He's out every day, work or not work, on the courts for several hours. And his other main hobby is sketching, mainly ink drawings.
Is it a recent innovation, this, or has it been something...
Oh, no, he has done this since he was a child. And that's one of the things he appreciates most about being in Madrid.
What about painting? Does he feel inclined to perpetuate the memories of his filming ever by drawing, painting vistas or panoramas of these beautiful places you've been?
No, he doesn't paint anymore. He really just sketches, but he sketches a great deal people on the set, little free line drawings, and I think they're awfully good.
Are you a stern critic of his films? Oh, this is quite a
He thinks so. He thinks I'm very stern.
Did he come to you for advice at all when a problem presents?
Yes. He does. We talk over various aspects of the work. I have discovered, however, that it's better not to give direction. One director on a picture is enough. I learned that for sure years ago. I remember he was doing a sequence in a play called Phaedra, which you probably know.
Yes.
And I gave him a piece of direction. He was to go up and touch a marble column when he actually should have been pulling it up by the roots and throwing it away. And I realized instantly when I saw it in production that I had made a big mistake. And since then, I give no direction. I give comments afterwards. But I left the
happy married life behind you, Mrs. Heston. You are disproving this old story that you can't remain happily married in Hollywood. What kind of formula would you personally recommend for a long, happy marriage over there?
Find the right man. Actually, I don't have any deep secret. I think a certain amount of compromise with the circumstances of the work is necessary. I think being willing to write letters and make phone calls and make trips when you can is very important. And, of course, the children have to take some of the burden of that.
Yes.
But on the whole, I think it's a question of finding a man who really wants to be married.
Well, you've certainly found one. Mrs. Heston, thank you for telling us about life with Charlton Heston.
It was a great pleasure.
Thank you.